Wonderful people, fellow couch gamers, fellow PC gamers, console gamers, welcome to Couch Gaming TV. In this video, I will explain how to abuse mesh holes. And what are you gonna do, Wildcard? Are you gonna ban me? I guess not, because you've already banned me. What are you gonna do? You're gonna ban me again? Fix your shit, Wildcard. Let's change account. It's very easy and I'm really sick of it, so I'm gonna make this video in the hope that Wildcard finally fixes it. Just remove chairs, remove sleeping bags, change beds, the teleporter, and just fix the textures. I don't get it. Okay, whatever. Let's go show where I entered this hole. I'm going to show you mesh pots in Valguero. Only in Valguero, because I am too lazy to load up another map. I might do Ragnarok some other day. And there are tons of ways to mesh. So this is a mesh hole I had built and got banned in, obviously. I always get banned. I was looking for mesh holes. I was like flying over here. And then I saw like an irregularity in the wall, actually, not in the floor. I saw an irregularity in the wall, because I saw the wall. It's actually hard to see in the darkness right now, because I saw the wall running down deeper. I didn't saw this hole from that far, but I saw that this wall extended deeper than this side. So I was like, I'm gonna check this out, because you wanna look for weaknesses in how they develop the map. One weakness you wanna look for are structures. For some reason, it's very hard to finish all the textures around structures. The second weakness you want to look for is ground levels. You will rarely find any mesh pots high up, unless it's straight up in the ceiling. But on the walls, rarely. What you want to look for is the ground level, or basically near the ground level, where you will have a lot of these holes or a lot of similar holes. So I'm gonna take off ghost mode. Now you can see we have this little place here, not much space to build. I'm gonna show you exactly where you can go in order to get behind this wall and get in another really nice camouflaged area. Just keep in mind, if you build a base in the mesh, set your turrets to a shorter range or be deep enough so your turrets won't shoot players running above the mesh, or you will be discovered. Also, do not have any parasaurs on detect mode, because if you detect players who have more than one IQ, they will figure out there's someone meshing. So you can walk around this place and you can try to get in this hole, but to get around you need to go through here. Sneak and sneak on this ledge. Don't go to the lower area, because you will clip through. Sneak on the slope here. You see, it's a little bit sloped where I'm sneaking on. Don't worry about that. Don't fall in. Don't fall in that hole there. I almost fell in. So you can stand up straight here, and below the water here you have an excellent hiding place. Now there's a really pretty easy to get there. All you need is parachute or a zipline, but I prefer to use a parachute for the first couple of times, because without a straight clear anchor point you will have no way of knowing if your zipline connected, and you might fuck it up, so to speak. Now where's the parachutes? I can never find... Oh, there they are. So many parachutes. And all you gotta do is... It really doesn't matter which running speed you got. Just make sure you're on sprinting. And just... You don't even gotta jump. But you can jump. But I'm not gonna jump. Because if your running speed is too fast, you might actually just clip to the floor. So I'm not gonna jump. Just gonna sprint and run straight off, and immediately deploy my parachute. Hop. very simple. So here's the floor, and then you can set up some pillars to create an anchor point, which will reach not really an anchor point, but a reference point, which will reach above the water, and then you can shoot right in front of it, because you want to destroy the anchor point, because below the water here, if people use orbit cam, they will not be able to see you. You will be able to see a black water up to a certain depth. I tried it, it's 1.5 ceilings tall, but there's actually like dark corners, these overhangs, which can reach up to 2.5 ceilings, I think, before it shows up above the mesh. You can also build a ladder up here and put some like chests here where you wanna switch the stuff you wanna put down. So you put like some chests behind this rock, and then you can transfer your gear. Actually, this is a pretty bad spot, because if you build a ladder here, they might be able to see it. What I did was, I meshed everywhere, by the way. I had my fertilizers down here. You can block this off so you don't fall down. People cannot see it from upstairs. I had some chests there. I had some chests hidden in the bushes here. I had most of my dinos, and they never got discovered, by the way, which is pretty cool. So I had some more crates here. Don't fall in that hole. I'm gonna clip out right now. I had some chests here. I had all my dinos hidden behind these things. Gotta be careful, because sometimes spinos and crabs might spawn in the textures in the mesh there, which might be unfortunate for you. Also, there's a little hidden cave. I like to call it that, my small SM dungeon, where I whip my animals, my dinos. No, not really, it's just a small cave where you can hide like smaller dinos, like Theomias. Ravagers won't get through, scorpions won't get through, Parasaurus definitely won't get through. But you can fit Theomias through, and raptors also won't fit through, I think. Can build some small stuff here. We're gonna go back under the textures once more. Oh yeah, if you want water, I'm gonna explain that in like 10 minutes. If you want water, if you want access to running water, I mean, because you can get water anywhere. Underground. You can get from that spot and some other spots I'm gonna show you. You can get under the map in this aberration zone in the Emerald Forest. Anywhere. You can get anywhere. You can mesh everyone. Don't get stuck in this hole. There's a lot of these crevices in the map, also on the textures. Look, I'm gonna show you. You get stuck in it like that. It's really fucked, especially if you get like an animal in there. Really fucked. There's a lot of places like that. It's just bad design. So this ends here, but you can jump down here. I also had a mesh base here. It's pretty deep. And I had my dinos hidden here. You can connect this with cliff platforms all the way to here. But you can also just run from here. Easy water access down in the swamp, right there. That's running water access, because as you know, you can get water anywhere. You don't need access to running water. So you run around this whole area, and then it stops here, but you can build some platforms here or some ceilings and whatnot, and connect this. I did this on live. This all goes pretty simple. You got the crystals over there, and I had my chests hidden behind, in between these rocks, and I put a floor here so I could jump up, because this is the crystal mine. is also a very, very, very well hidden base location up there. Which obviously can be meshed from my method variety. Now there's a lot of cool things I want to show you guys, so this video might be a tad bit long. I'm gonna speed up and skip a whole lot of things, but it's still gonna be a tad bit long. So and then you can build this upwards also. I also did this on live, and you can also just cross this, put a whole set of floors over this, no problem. Just be careful, because you're gonna get discovered one day. You can put more platforms here, then with a zip line across, tuk 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 tuk, platforms all the way around, and then you are in a mesh pot. However, that is not the entrance that I used. The entrance that I used, however, was easier, closer, yet more intuitive. And the way I tap water, no, that's a whole other story. That's the hardest thing I ever did in Ark. Get running water behind this wall. So just be careful not to clip through. And here, let's equip my other crossbow. This is pretty easy too. Load up your arrow or your hookshot, whatever. Parachute, you want to get under this and behind this. Why did I stop? I suddenly lost all momentum, but it doesn't matter. So you got the wall there, which only loads on one side, and I had triangle ceilings in here, triangle foundations, because if you don't know, which you should, triangle foundations are glitched and you can place them pretty much in any cliff. Any triangle foundation, and if you line them up just right, you can put multiples. But if you don't line it up right, you won't be able to put multiples. You see, I had my beds up in there. I had it a little bit lower. I had a whole stack of little crates right here, ta 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 ta. Because if you look from orbit cam from over there, then it just looked like a black smudge. I used wood, painted it black, painted it all black. Now we're gonna go through the wall. And I had another set of chests all here, to put my stuff over. And then I didn't block this off, because if you block it off, people don't even have to destroy it. They're immediately gonna see, oh, something is up. I'm gonna check that out in a fly mode. They're gonna come here in a fly mode like I'm doing now, and they're gonna see that. So I had my decoy base over here. And as you can see, like, I put up some decoy walls and stuff, and then you can put your crates there and access it through the wall. Boom, throw your pokeball down, boom, have like 5 crates here full with stuff, boom boom boom, switch it all into your dino. Up, you run with your dino here. If you need multiple runs, stack into the chest there. If you don't need multiple runs, jump over the chest, go around, boom, you're in your base, easy as that. And then if you have ravagers, you can do something like this. I advise to grapple yourself to the ceiling first, because shooting tripwires the other way around is pretty hard. You always want to start from your feet. So as you can see, we have another platform here, which if you have access to Ravagers, you're gonna utilize this a lot. You can build on top of that, you can reach that, you can reach the whole map from here. Oh yeah, I already put a wire here, because I always test everything out offline before I do it online, so it always works from the first time and I don't have to waste any resources. So with the Ravager you can walk on there, then I add another one from here. Oh, I already got one? Why didn't I see this? From there, boom, easy access. Very easy access. And then I had another dummy base right here. Boom, 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 set up. All around foundations. Tuck, 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 tuck. And not in the middle, because in the middle on the floor I had my crates. Pop, 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 pop. And then I could access it from the bottom. I had a weight ravager with only weight. So then I did like, you could jump down here, but it was very dangerous. Very dangerous. So I always used the safe ways. It was only like a 30 second walk, not even that. Boom, you are in your base. Now I'm going to show you how you can get running water. I'm going to show it in creative mode, because I'm not gonna do it again how I did it. So we start out, well, you can start out there. You will need climbing picks, a whole lot of pipes, a few climbing picks, a whole lot of hook shots and all that. Triangle ceilings, those are your friends. You can start with your climbing picks from there, or if you wanna save up some uses, go into the mesh hole, blah blah blah. Start from here. So you can jump on this, go here, go into this little crevice, that's the only safe spot, go around here and stand as far as you can on this ledge before you stand up, parachute over there. Oh shit, oh that's it, it's the wrong one. Oh, you see, I already got my wires here. So I don't have a climbing pick right now. And this is built in creative mode, so I could put the pipes anywhere. But I did this on live as well. And to be able to do it on live, you just put your triangle ceiling down. Because we have access to water over here. Can you see? And if I do my cam close, so you can see there's no water here. But as soon as I go here, we get water. So actually, on this point, if we would get to this point. Whoa, that was too far. Well, I'm in creative mode now, so it doesn't matter. But be careful, if you swim forward, you're gonna fall down. You see? Because it's not dangerous now if I go in the water, because I have unlimited breath and I can fly. But whatever you do not want to go into the water. Just stick to that side a little bit. Then put like these ceilings down. Oh, I cannot do this in third person. Oh wait. Yes. Let's go for a swim. So you put the ceiling down, and on the ceiling, on the triangle thingy, you can put the intake pipe down. It's really hard, it's probably not gonna work from the first time, but you can do that. And then you have to connect a few things on that, put a bed on there, put a few stupid things on that, make sure there's like 7 objects on it so it doesn't auto decay after 3 days. Because otherwise the intake pipe is also gonna auto decay. Be sure to finish this in one go. See, with the climbing picks, then you can just pop, 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 do it all the way around. Be sure to do it in one go, because if you log off for too long, it can auto decay. Nobody will be able to see this. I had it in stone on live server, and it never got destroyed, never. So nobody can see this. Just go all the way around. As you can see, I really test all my shit. I really test all my shit before doing it on live service, because I want to be as stealthy as possible. Didn't want to go just the way around, because you can orbit cam there and you would be able to see that. I went all this way, and then poof, over there, and that's the way I had my warden. That was the hardest thing I ever did, because if you fall down there, there's a 50% chance you won't teleport, you will hit the dead zone. And even if you do teleport, you will teleport straight up above the textures, above the aberration cave, I mean, and with no way, with no immediate way back down. So I have shown you this whole part. You can go there as well, but it ends this few skippity-dabbity-doobity across this fake river, because this is no water. The water starts there, as I have shown you. You skippity-dabbity-doobity across this, there's nothing here. So that's pretty much this mesh pot. And right over there is the Wyvern Trench. As you can see on the map, that crevice, that's the Wyvern Trench. And as you may or may not know, dung beetles can be found in the Wyvern Trench. I'm gonna have to find the exact, I think the exact spot is here. And they are probably not going to load because I am in single player, but in multiplayer on live servers you can actually see dung beetles there and wyverns flying around. And how did I discover that? I just saw like this wall lighting up at random times, and I went to check it out, and there were like fire wyverns flying behind this wall. And if you go there, you will go into loading zone, you see. Boom. So theoretically, I think, this cave looks nice like that, no? I think you might be able to pull dung beetles into existence from here. And there's like places like this, I don't know if this is a place, but there are places like this where you put a tree platform behind these walls and you can actually fly on your mount, and you can fly all the way up on top of the cave and under the overworld. But the tricky part is the loading zones are a bitch and they fuck you over. But I had found a safe spot, which I will show in another video, because that's like the master, that's like the Dark Souls of mesh pots, that one mesh pot. So I'm not gonna give it away in this video. I'm gonna save the best for later. But if you have a teleport or anything like that, I mean, this game is made for cheaters. And then they put Pokeballs in this game, I mean, come on, there was no reason whatsoever to put Pokeballs in this game. As you can see, if you're in between two loading zones, some textures will load and other textures won't load, and if you're not in creative mode, you might get stuck in them. But as I have said, I have found a safe place in Aberration. It's like, you know, you can go into the trees, but then you cannot go higher than the ceiling. There's a place where you can go higher than the ceiling. It's not, it doesn't start in a tree, but it, you gotta go into the tree to go through the textures, basically. And there only one zone loads, so you can go all the way up, and you can see the floor from the, see, there are animals loading there. And I mean, you can build here. You can build here. I know I'm in creative mode, but it does work on live service. I'm not a dumbass idiot like most of these guys. They say, "Oh, found a mesh bot," and they do some stupid sleeping bag tricks that only works in creative mode and offline, with the building restrictions set off and all that. Don't follow that stupid shit, those stupid tricks. That doesn't work. I test everything before I say it will work, so you can be sure it works. And if it doesn't work, A, you're doing it wrong, B, it got patched. But I mean, just imagine building here. Who's gonna find you? Who's gonna detect you? Who's ever gonna report you? No one. No one. This wasn't possible on any other map, as far as I'm aware of. It was only possible on this map. Oh, it's so bright all of a sudden. Is this normal? Alright, so unfortunately I cannot test out my theory on offline servers because the animals won't load. Oh yeah, before I forget, some people might be wondering like, what the hell's this guy talking about? You can get water anywhere. Water anywhere without access to water. Are you a joker? You need reservoirs. Regular reservoirs, no reservoir dogs. They won't do you any good in getting water. And all you wanna do is just connect some pipes. Easy pipes. And then after a little while, wrong button again, you will have water because of in-game mechanics. And if it rains, even if it doesn't rain, these will slowly fill up. Even if it doesn't rain, I don't know why, condensation perhaps, but they will fill up, and after a while you will have water. Access to water. We're probably gonna connect a few more to be able to show this properly, because I know it does work with stone. Maybe I need to go out of render range for something to happen. I think that's far enough. There it is. Slowly starting to fill up. Voila, and there you got it, water. And there's no tricks up my sleeve. I didn't troll you guys. There's nothing connected to this pipe. No intake pipes, just plain water reservoirs connected to a water tap. It's as simple as that. The water is infinite as long as you don't drink it. If you start drinking the water or use it for cooking, these are gonna drain. But if you have a whole lot, it really doesn't matter. You can just glitch them in one another and have access to infinite water. Alright, I thank you all for watching and see you on the next part. Bye bye!